Come in this way.
31-year-old Kristen Cross is a stay-at-home mother of four, an avid baker, a talented photographer, a piano teacher, and the brains and charm behind her blog, The Frugal Girl.
People always said, oh, you should write a book about saving money. And I was like, I don't have time to write a book.
The Frugal Girl is chock full of Kristen's money-saving ways. Some of the most popular posts have to do with baking at home, shopping at Goodwill, painting wooden furniture, and air-drying laundry. She's also shared about using rags made from old t-shirts instead of paper towels. And she makes her own gifts, like these scrapbooks and framed pictures. The blog is not even 2 years old, yet the number of visitors has steadily multiplied.
Constantly amazed at how many people come to read what I have to say.
And Kristen tells us that this site that averages more than 2,300 hits a day and sometimes gets more than 70,000 hits a month all started with a goal to better herself.
Back in March of 2008, I started getting frustrated with the amount of food that I wasted. I cleaned out my fridge one day and I looked at this pile of food on my kitchen floor and I thought how embarrassed I would be if anybody else took a look at that. And then I was like, hey, I could have everybody else look at my food waste and then maybe I would be more motivated.
So she started taking pictures of the food she had to throw out. Each week she posted pictures online. It was a hit. The experiment eventually evolved into what is now known as the Frugal Girl.
Now I have other people shaming themselves along with me. When other bloggers post about their food waste, they can link to my blog on Fridays so we can all go look at their food waste too. Public embarrassment is very motivating.
She calls it Food Waste Friday, and it's very popular. Another weekly feature is Wednesday Baking. Kristen is a baking whiz and writes detailed, photo-filled posts on making homemade breads, coffee cake, glazed rolls, you name it. And while baking is big around the Frugal House, her number one tip?
If you try nothing else, try planning your menu.
She aims to spend no more than $100 a week on groceries. That's to feed her family of six.
I make my shopping list when I plan my menu.
She pays cash.
Be careful with the cucumbers.
And shops only once a week. Kristen's top money-saving tips for grocery shopping? Stick to the list. Cut back on the amount of meat you eat. Stock up on items when they're on sale. Don't buy single-serving items. And learn to cook from scratch. And how's this for transparency? She posts exactly how much she spends and pictures of her groceries online. The week we tagged along, her total was $99.93. Her frugal ways don't stop at the grocery store. She racks up savings when it comes to her household, too. They keep the thermostat between 63 and 66 degrees in the winter and at 80 degrees in the summer, which she estimates saves about 30% in energy costs. They don't have cable, but watch little TV anyway. She and her husband do have cell phones, but they only buy prepaid minutes and don't use their phones to go on the internet or send texts. In many ways, Kristen, who is shy by nature, has found a ministry in writing online. She's able to reach out to people all over the world.
Many, many days I get emails from readers who say they've saved so much on their grocery bill because of reading my blog, or they're not wasting food, or they've started baking, or they're thinking about going back to church because of the things that I've said on my blog. So there's just piles and piles of emails. It's amazing to see the way that God has used me.
She laughs that he chose her because she thinks she has an unriveting story.
A lot of personal finance bloggers and frugal bloggers have these amazing stories. Like, I was in credit card debt up to my eyeballs, and then in a year I paid it all off, and here I am. And so sometimes I feel a little bad that I don't have a more exciting story.
She and her husband are debt-free except for their mortgage. They pay cash for their vehicles and save for vacations and Christmas. And whenever possible, they buy used items, either online or during their weekly trips to the thrift store.
Did you find something good?
Kristen has even been featured on other blogs for the cute clothes she's found at Goodwill. And her kids wear a lot of hand-me-downs or clothes also bought at secondhand stores. or from FreeCycle, an online network that helps people give things away. As for the future of the Frugal Girl, she's been asked to do some public speaking, which she's afraid of, and she's been approached to do reality television, but she has no interest in that either. So the Frugal Girl feels right at home with her kids, blogging her life away, living cheerfully on less.
Put this in our bags. Do you have the bags?
Jennifer Wishon, CBN News.